namely sattva, raja, and tamas. Sattva is soft, white color, pure. And rajogana is red color, color and authority and all that. Tamaha is dark color. So all these three are mixed in that. That's why idam tu evat prayam gunanam prayam vipati. So identity with Devi's eyes, and so she is Trigunatmika Parvati. And this is one we see in general, but another version of imagining or interpreting this as the that Devi withdrew the three murtis, that is Brahma, Vishnu, Rudra, at the time of deluge, and they are just reprojected or recreated when once the creation has got to be started. So these three deities are withdrawn into her eyes. So she bears all the three colors in her eyes, and also the three gunas, which are represented by the Prajapati, Vishnu, and Shiva. So, and Devi, owing to the anointment with dark delirium, to her eyes look beautiful, having dark lining to show out beauty of eyes. In view of these three deities, the colors appear, and otherwise her eyes look free from color at all. And generally, for great saint and rich men and women, there would be the red lines in the eyes, while the Aksha, the eyeball, is white and Chakshu is dark. So Devi's eyes bear these three colors only to create the three murtis. And here, the imagination of Shankara is true, as we find the corresponding names in Milta's Dasanamambita. I told you this Soundarya Lahari is a commentary to some of the names of Lalita Parameswari from Lalita Sahasranama. Here, she has to create back. She not only takes them inside, but also she has to bring it back. So we have got the expression, Leela Kalpita Brahmandamandala is Lalita. Because she is creating the Brahmandamandala, it's only a sport for her. And again, she gives good work for Narayana. That is what we see, Karanguri Nakhotpanna Narayana Dashakruti. All the 10 Akrutis and Avataras came up because of her Karanguri Nakha, the nail of the finger of her eye, her hand. And again, her eyes are having this, I mean, eyelids. She opens the eyes and closing the eye. This kind of opening and closing will be very interestingly imagined to be, as you see, Unmesha Nimisha Utpanna Vipanna Bhuvanavali. See, the Bhuvanavali, Avali means the series. We have got Chaturdasha Bhuvanas. 14 Bhuvanas are there. And the entire world, the entire Bhuvanas, the series of the Bhuvanas are worlds. Are created Utpanna when she is Utmesha, when she opened the eyes, and Nimesha when it closed, and so on. So, although the wife of Vishana, Rita, bears different colors in her, but they are all one and one energy only. See, the activity of dissolution and creation and maintenance of the world, all these things are being controlled by her three eyes. And therefore, these attributes represent qualities of Prakriti in her. That is, she is creative, active, and sleeping, slumber. So, this is all the meaning of this particular sloka. And Traivarnyam, to just give you the meanings of some words, Yati Kalita, done in semi-circular way, and Leela for sport, Anjana is the anointment of the Kupalam, and Druhina is Brahma, Hari is Vishnu, and Rudran. See, Rudran is a plural. There are several Rudras. You know, in Rudra Sukhtam, you find first few Anuvatas describe the Rudra as an individual deity. And he has got a big parivara also, Rudras. They are available in any and everywhere in the universe upon the earth. Therefore, see, the word Rudran, they come to the number of Rudras. And they are all working to protect the land at any and every place of the universe. Therefore, and not only them, she has to create the gods again back in the same manner. That's why Devan, a brilliant personality. So she is having all that power endured in her eyes, which are red, white and dark in complexion. And so Devi has this unique complement that though she has got that but she has got also steady eyes, and thereby she is able to do perfect maintenance of the world at the same time, annihilation and creation. So that's what is seen in the eyes, because many times the eye will be also a medium for communication, more so is in the dance. So they represent, they are looking at the eyes, people will imagine so many messages too. The alankara of the eyes of the Ishara Dalita is eulogized in such a prayer to them. And it is a wonderful jnana sloka to imagine the eyes. You know, we have got so many descriptions about the eyes, beautiful eyes and messages and maintenance of the eyes. That's why the devis are called by taking the eye as an important aspect of her personality. So like Kamakshi, Meenakshi, Usharakshi, Kanjadalayatakshi, etc. So the Akshi or Aksha, both are very important. And this particular sloka, when we put for japa or dhyana and all that, this will help us to have safe travel, sukha prayana, and also whatever works or projects we have undertaken, that will be successful. And this is a very powerful, useful sloka. Now I am going to the 54th sloka. It is again very very interesting, powerful sloka. Though the slokas appear to be the varnana of the different parts of the body of Devi, but they are not simply physical ones, but they have many other powerful communications to give to us, depending upon the view which the devotee takes looking at her. After all, she is always live and she is always active, live, omnipresent, to be able to guide all people at all times. Now I am going to 54th sloka. Om pavitri kartum naha pasupati paradhina hrudaye daya mitrai netrai arunadhavala syamanchivihi nadashyono ganga tapana tadaye jitravamayam trayanam jitthanam. I repeat, Pavitri Kattum Naha Pasupati Paradhina Hrudaye Dayaditrahir Netrai Arunadhamalasyama Rushidhi Nadashyonu Ganga Tapanatanaye Jitruvam Ayam Trayanam Jitthanam Upanayasa Sambedamanakam. So anakam dhruvam chitta trayanam chitthanam sambedham upanayasi. This is the gist of that. So here we have the activity of Devi signified in the word pavitri kartum. What her entire effort is to make people purified. Even the impure people means even the sinners are freed from sin. And they are made free, they are made sinless, and they will become eligible for higher experiences. Therefore, everything depends upon her. She has to enable her devotees to grow higher up into the levels of happiness. And that's why Pavitri Kattum is a beautiful expression. In fact, what happens to those people who attain the purification, who are removed from the sin doshas in Narada Prashna of Yajur Veda, probably we must have heard about it. It's a very important text, Saitanya Arindaka, where there are 32 passages describing the Surya Bhagavan and his power. Surya and Lalita Parameswara are the same only. Therefore, we have got the indication that the expression Pavitravan Dapariva Javasate Itaisam Pratmo Adirakshati Uratam. That's the expression. So, Pavitravantaha Parivaja Masate. That's what is why what in communicate. That those people who are purified, they become eligible for all sorts of higher benefits. And spiritually and otherwise also, they get Parivajam. Vaja is gift. Vaja is many things. So, Parivaja Masate. And Pratam Adhirakshati. So, another important word that we have to catch here is Pashupati Paradina Urdhaye. See, her heart and soul and mind, everything is in favor of Pashupati. That is Lord Shiva. You know, in earlier sloka, you have got the name Ishara given to that. In fact, the entire Mahanyasa is done for the Ishara Swarup of that. So Ishara Mava here. Ishara Dhyana is there. Like that here in this Pashupati Para. Pashupati is the lord of all animals. All are animals only. Pashu means beast. What is beast? Beast has only to work on instinct and nature and will not have any discrimination. And is just controlled by the indriyas. So the word Pashu has all that animal. And but Pati is the Shiva. He is able to control and make the Pashus also rise in their own levels. So, and that means Pashupati Paradhina Vrataye means that she is able to take care of Pashus and make them elevated to and get their mind freed from contaminations and sin and present them with good buddhi so that they can work for higher things. And one other meaning of the word Pashu means that he is liable to be tied to a pole and never made it as independent unless it is tied to the pole. We are all suffering. We are all safe. But that's why that kind of liability in a Pashu will be removed by the grace and looks of the Pashupati Parajina Pradaya Lalita Parameshwari. So Devi is liking such a Lord who is committed to hopeful activity of unifying Pandha, untying the Pandhas. You know, and that's why you remember, I don't know all of many of you married, at the time of marriage, people make the promise. So the marriage, they say, Pashurme Kamaha. See, my desires are just that of the Pashu, a beast, an animal, an ordinary animal. But from that level, because of the great Kalyana Parampara, good things, they have to rise high. And therefore, we have got the ashrama system introduced as Brahmacharya, and then Grihastha, Vanaprastha, and then Sannyasa. It's all these ashramas. So anyway, here, the untying the bandhas is the most important thing. And besides our effort, there should be the grace, the looks of Parameshwari. And another important thing that we note here is Daya Vitrayi Netrayi. See, her eyes have got two important blessing qualities. One is Daya and another is Mitratva. One is the kindness and another is the friendship. When kindness and friendship go hand in hand, there will be absolute success. There would not be any kind of difference. That's exactly what is called as good friendship. You know, Sugriva and Rama, between each other, there is a lot of kindness and there is a lot of friendship and there is working. So that is supposed to be the best example for best friends. So that kind of feeling and looks are there in the eyes of Parameshwari. And at the same time, they have the three ruchis. Ruchi is the kanti, ruchi is the brilliance. What are the ruchis? Aruna, Dhavana and Shyama. Aruna is love, that is red color, and Dhavana is white and Shyama is dark. So these are all the three kinds of feelings, kinds of aspects that the Devi has through her glances upon the devotees. And again, the sight line or the looks of the eye is always should be continuously flow. You cannot have any stoppage or cessation or intermission for the looks. The look must be, the moment you open your eyes, the eyes constantly flow of its vision. Like that, it is something like compared to the rivers. The flow of sentiment of love is likened to the three rivers, Sona River, Bhadra Sona, Bhadra River, Ganga River, and Yamuna River. So these three rivers have got that sambhedam, that is, they have got confluence of all these things. That's what we call Trayanam, Tithanam, Titha is river, and Trayat. So here, Ganga, the Sona River is red color, and Ganga is water is white color, Yamuna water is dark color. Yamuna Nadi, see who is Yamuna? Tapana Taraya. Yamuna is the daughter of Tapana, is Surya Bhagavan. So therefore, Tapana Taraya, daughter of sun, she has made a dark color. That's why when you go to prayer, Arava, that Divine Sangama, you are told, you will see the color of the waters, where the two rivers, the Saraswati, of course, down inside, you may not be able to see Saraswati, but you have the influence or feeling of that. So, she is bearing all those colors in her eyes. The three tithas are brought at one place for confluence, the name Triveni is Allahabad. So, they bear a touch of purity with all these aspects to the devotees involved in them. So, here she bears also three gunas in her eyes, beside her three in her eyes, three eyes, and it is like Sona, Nadi, that is Saraswati River, Ganga and Yamuna, confluencing with the name Triveni. And Sambhega is an interesting word. Sanskrit language is really a great language where the vocabulary is tenable for any type of meaning and all kinds of interpretation depending upon the pratibha, pitrati, paranitya of the person who wants to look at it. So here the word Sambhega is only to, it talks about the effort to purify and free them from doshas or sins. Therefore, this is a very, very powerful sloka where there is a purity acquired because of this. And normally, this sloka is employed for removal of the Narma Vyadhi Nashana. Narma Vyadhi Nashana is probably what you call, if I forgot the name. Anyway, all secret diseases which cannot be HIV, they call it, HIV kind of things, to get rid of that kind of. And again, this loka is important for getting rid of the kidney problems and diabetics. And so that's why it has got medical application also. And actually, one has to experiment, put to japa, puja and all that, and they will slowly experience the effect of this. That's why all these lokas have got magical importance besides other importance also. And the Ganga and Yamuna are the two eyes. The space between the two eyes is Bhrumadhya, and that Bhrumadhya is supposed to be Sona Nadi. So in the forehead of the Fala Bhaga, the forehead of Devi, there is a sangam of all these rivers, and there is the effect of Pavitri Karna to devotees. The right eye of Devi is Rajoguna, the left eye of Devi is Sattvaguna, and the Palanetra is Tamoguna. But for the purpose of creation, the character of all these three gunas join to manifest in the form of Brahma, Vishnu, Maheshwara, and the unison, however, emerge the sentiment of Karuna and love, the Mitrata Bhava. And so there is a kind of unification, though difference is seen, but ultimately there is a unity or unification. Something like, though we have got two eyes, the sight is only one. Like that, the rasa, even among rasas, though there are nine rasas, a great poet and dramatist by name Bhavabhuti makes a thesis in his drama called Uttararamadaritam. He brings out that Eko Rasa Karuna Eva Nimitta Veda Prudat Prudat Bhavati. There is only one rasa, and that one rasa is the Karuna, compassion, graciousness, kindness. But that only will take different names and forms, and therefore the Karuna is that. That's why in Ramayana, although there are so many rasas depicted, but the entire Ramayana is only a Sokarasa, which is Thayi Bhava Karuna. So in that manner, she has so many things in her eyes, but for the general public, for general devotees, she always shows forth the kindness or compassion upon them. So Karuna is the seat of productivity of all rasas. And there is a comparison of rivers for the rice. And Naga is one which flows to west, and Nadi is one which flows to the east, both rivers. And this is the distinction between rivers. Kokanadam, Ganga Nadi distinguish themselves in their directions of flow. So we understand that she has to have the loka vyavahara done, because what is the loka vyavahara or the ways of the world? Kalidasa beautifully tells about this in Malavagni Mitra, talking about the dance. He says, Raigunyotvamatra loka dharitam nanarasam sevate. So, the entire loka dharitam of the history or the movement or activity of the people in the world connect itself to Traigunya, Sattva, Rajas, Tamogunas. But though it has got so many different rasas, but ultimately life is same, Traigunya. And that's why in the world the activity refers to the three gunas and various sentiments. And that is, it is hard to find people of one mind. It is all they disport to see the world in a motley form. You cannot find one-minded people. It's very hard. Everybody, if there are 10 people in a group, there are 10 opinions. And people search for the unified opinion to act at all. So the words in this sloka have suggestive flair for Vini Yoga. And especially this sloka is important for ladies. When they turn to cross the menstrual cycle, white problem, supposed to menstrual cycle problems, they get it. A parayana of this sloka for japa will help them to get rid of the problems of such complaint. And also for all gynic problems, you know, for ladies, the sloka recitation is advised. And even in respect of men, not necessarily for ladies, even men also are not, and they will be getting relief from the genital problems. Therefore, the very aspect of pavitri kattum naha pasupati parparatina hrudaye is appropriately thought of by Shankaracharya, that she is all-round powerful deity, that she is able to make people purify, though in her she imbibes all the defenses, but ultimately her looks, her grace and her kindness is only one, and that's what is being explained in this beautiful, powerful sloka. And now I go to the next sloka, very important too. So you will see, when you are reading the sloka or reciting, and when you spend some time academically to understand what Shankaracharya is doing, And again, you see, he is not repeating. He is every time giving new flair or kahar, the aspect of Parameshwari, and describing her Ananta Rupatvam, Ananta Gunatvam, and Ananta Mahima also. And again, in the 55, you find some more important information regarding her eyes only. Because once eyes is there, the fluttering of the eyes, the eyelids, eye fluttering of the eyelids is also important. And we do it, all human beings will do Nivesha Unmeshas. But Devi, all gods do not at all have that kind of fluttering of the eyelids. They remain constant and stable. And Shankaracharya sees meaning in the Nimesha Unmesha and also stoppage. And Parihruta Nivesha, that is trying to stop it of the eyelids movement. So interesting sloka, let's read now. Om Nimeshonmeshabhyam Pralayamudayam Yati Jagato Tadeti Ahu Santaha Dharanidhara Rajan Yatanaye Tadunmeshajyatam Jagadidamase Samprayata Paritratum Senke Parihruta Nimeshatavadusha. Nimeshonmeshabhyam Pralayamudayam Yati Pralayamudayam Yati Jagato Tava Iti Ahu Santaha Dharanidharajanyataraye Tadunmeshajyatam Tiridamatesam Pralayataha Paritratum Shenke Parihruta Nimeshastavadrushaha. In the poetry, in the Kavyas, that is that Utpreksha, and that Utpreksha are trying to imagine. The poet has got no capitals or no limitations, no. He is a Nirankushaha Kavayaha. The poets are all having no Ankusha. They can imagine any and anything depending upon their Pratibha, Vipatti, and imaginative powers. Therefore, that particular imaginatory power, Shankaracharya is no less a poet, though it is taken as a Laghu Kavya, a lyric containing only 100 slokas, a devotional lyric. But you know, in Sanskrit we have got two kinds of Kavyas. One is Mahakavya, another is called Laghu Kavya. Mahakavya is Kumara Sambhava, Raghu Vamsha, Naishwaram. These are all called Mahakavya. They run long. But Laghu Kavyas, they are short, 100 slokas normally. So here, in this 100 slokas, he is able to tell you, Senke, the word Senke, you have to catch it. And Paritratum Senke, why you imagine like that? It is only her eyelids activity is only to protect the land, to see that people are having constant grace and kindness spread upon them. It's something like the earth rotating constantly with 1,000 mile speed. Because earth is rotating, we are all stable. If the earth is taking some difference in the rotation, they are revolving, people will be restless. That's why, Bhu Devi, we have to thank her very much. She is constantly bearing everybody, whether good, bad, or different, she is bearing because of her constancy that she is doing. So like that, Shankaracharya's imagination goes like that, something like the earth moving. So, Sinke Paritratum Parinimeshaha Tavadrushaha. Tavadrushaha, Dushaha is the vision, or the looks. The vision is not disturbed. It is constantly flowing, in spite of her other movements, or no movements of her eyelids. The Nimesha Unmesha Bhyam Yajataha Pralayam Udayam Yati. Because of her Nimesha, Nimesha is opening, closing down. Unmesha is opening up. Because of that kind of activity of eyelids, Nimesha gives rise for Pralaya, annihilation, and Unmesha gives for the creation, Udaya, beginning of the world. So the Jagataha is the world. So the world is having these two activities And that's always there, in and out, that is normal. And it's nobody can escape this. That's why in Bhagavad Gita, you see, Adhyavanta Ive Sukha Dukha Yodaya Eva Te. Krishna told Arjuna, hey, you think that going home and think, from the battleground not doing the war, you can say, Sukha, no. Any Sukha which has an origin is always a scope for, has always scope for Dukkha only. There are 12 Dukkhas. Among 12 Dukkhas, the Sukha is also considered a Dukkha. You can start thinking about it. So, Divesha Unvesha Abhyam Jagataha Pralayam Udayam Yati. So, because of her eyelid, they're moving. That's why in Lalita Sastram also it comes across that Unvesha Nimishotpanna Ipanna Puvanavari is there. Same concept has been just copied down, decoction, and said, Shankaracharya tells it like that. That is to say, Shankaracharya is a strong commentator, strong devotee of Lalita. He doesn't deviate or take out anything extra. What has already been told by Hayagriva to Agastya Maharshi, when Agastya Maharshi asked him to talk about the 1,000 names of Lalita, and so on. So here, you observe how much of similarity between Lalita and here. In fact, when you read Soundarya Lahari, it's almost covering the entire effect or mahim of Lalita Sahasana. Nimishon, Nimeshon, Mesha, Abhyam, Pralayam, Udayam, Yati, Negata. Next time, Tava, Iti, Ahuhu, Santaha. I am not. See, Shankaracharya does not take responsibility, but he is telling it. He is just putting the imagination upon others. That is Santaha, Santaha, Sadpurushaha. The saints are philosophers like Brahma and Indra and all these fellows, they only described earlier. Already Dhruhya Rudra, earlier we have already mentioned of these people, saying that they wanted to estimate the extent of beauty. Kavindra Agalpanti. So he said, Kalindra, Kalpante, Amma, they want to imagine how much beautiful you are. They wanted to equate, but they fail in that, describing the exquisite beauty and contraction and compression, etc. of daily. So in the same manner, Shankaracharya says, Tava Ahusantaha. So this is how, this is a quotation like, this is how all the Sadpurushas, all the devotees of you, looking at your eyelids, opening, closing, and all otherwise, describe that the entire world is being operated like that. And here, the other name has been given to Lalita, Parameshwarya, Sundar Lari Devata, you observe, Dharani Dharanajanya Dhanaye. See, Dharani Dharanajanya, Dharani Dharanajanya is the fountain. And Rajanya is the king, Himavan. Dharanya is the daughter. So you can imagine Dharani Dharas means there are stable things. That is, mountains to never, never shake, even when there is a hurricane, when there is a wind or hurricane or any kind of thing, the mountains don't shiver, don't shake, they're strong. Like that, her eyelids also remain strong. That's what is the comparison imagination. That's why Kalidasa says in Abhijnana Sakuntalam, Tanu Pravadevi Nishkampaha Nirayaha. The Nirayaha, the mountains, Nishkampaha, they don't come at all, they never shake. Even in Pravada, even there is very wild wind, the Dharanis do not at all shake. That is the firmness. So that's why, in order to describe, her eyelids remain constantly open and the grace flowing for the grace of looks, the gracious looks flowing forth from her eyes is being stressed here by saying, Dharani Dhara Rajanya Dhanaye, O you, the daughter of the king of all the mountains put together. And so that's what the compliment given to her. And one more, two names that Shankara gives in the Ramavadi. Third line, Tat Unmeshajatam Jagatvidam Ashesham Pralayataha. Pralayataha, అండ్ జాతం ఉన్మేష జగత్ ఇదం అశేషం తత్ ఉన్మేష. ఉన్మేష్ నిమిషాస్ సేమ్ ఐడియా విచ్ ఇస్ సెడ్ ఇన్ ది ఫస్ట్ లైన్ ఈస్ బీన్ డిఫరెంట్లీ టోల్డ్ బై పోయట్ ఇన్ సే దాట్ బికాస్ షీఈస్ హ్యావింగ్ ది క్వాలిటీ ఆఫ్ అవ్యాజ కరుణామూర్తి. She has her karuna shown upon people for no reason. She has not got any purpose. She is just constantly karuna. That's why Sakalidasa also says in Vesandesham that when the clouds come, and when the clouds tumble, the lions roar. And when the clouds come, the peacocks dance. Why? Anapeksha, they don't have any purpose. But it is their happiness and their nature, Subhava. Like that, here also, the same idea is being given to that, Avyaja Karuna Murti is Parameshwari. So, Pralayataha Jagatum, and Unmesha Jatam Jagat. And with this kind of activity of the eyelids of Parameshwari, one sometimes remaining, sometimes say, opening, sometimes closing, but however it is, is constantly open. So it's all over. I think that parinutanivesha, the fluttering of the eyes, our eyelids, stopped. Parinutam stopped. Tavatrusha, so that the flow of our looks can constantly be there. And why that paritratum? Only to protect the land constantly. So another thing is, interpretation could be the nature of female fish in the water and the opening and closing of the petals of Kuvalaya are described attributing this nature to be owing. See, the female fish inside the water will not flutter the eyelids. And the female fish in the water and the opening and closing of the petals of Kuvalaya are described attributing their nature to be owing to the beauty of eyes and ears of Sundari. It is a unique imagination of Shankara. And you know, each poet is very much Sutantra, that's what you said. And that's why we make a prayer to Shankaracharya that he is Sarvatantra Sutantra. And so we make a prayer to him like this, Sarvatantra Sutantraya. సదాత్మాద్వైతవేదినే శ్రీమతే శంకరార్యాయ వేదాంత గురవే నమః. బ్యూటిఫుల్ సర్వతంత్ర స్వతంత్ర. అండ్ ఈవెన్ లలితా శాస్త్రనామ ఓన్లీ ఆల్సో షీ డిస్క్రైబ్ లైక్ దట్ స్వతంత్ర సర్వతంత్రే శ్రీ దక్షిణా బుద్ధి రూపిణి అండర్స్టాండ్. సో స్వతంత్ర షీ ఇస్ హావింగ్ హర్ ఓన్ తంత్ర, హర్ ఓన్ మేనర్ ఆఫ్ డూయింగ్. There is no imitation at all in her manner of protecting the land and seeing that she is absolutely sitting upon that Sudantra Pita. That's why that's what is called a Sarvajna Pita. Only Shankaracharya has the greatest honor. I render to him in Kashmir, making him sit on the Sarvajna Pita. So he is called a Sarvajna and knowing any and everything. When he has to become also knowing about the Sringara Shastra, that Rati Shastra, and that's what the, to defeat that Mandana Mishra's wife, she questioned, did not accept the defeat. And for that purpose, he Shankaracharya made the Parakaya Pravesa, you know, and he learned all that. Came back and answered all the questions and then he became Sarvajna. He gave sannyasa to one. So that's how Shankaracharya goes like that. So that Tatantra, Sarvatantra, and that kind of Svatantra that he has taken. And when he says that, Dakshinamurti Rupini means, what is Dakshinamurti? He is simply a Jnanamurti. And when he is a Jnanamurti, there is nothing, not that, anything not known. So, here, here it is that I suspect, in essence, Devi has stopped the movement of eyelids to protect the world always. That's what is Shankara's contribution. The attribution to the looks and the eyelids movement are the activity in the world, positive and negative. They add to the balancing of both happenings in an effective manner. And it becomes, ultimately, what we look in Lalita is Matruka Varna Rupini. And so, she has to have Matru Karuna Drishti. That is, constant, uninterrupted flow of looks. You know, for a mother, the child is always lovable. Whatever, whoever, whatever, whichever it is, that's why Shankaracharya's thesis is Kuputro Jayeda Kochita Pita Kumata Vibhavati. There may be a bad boy, but there cannot be a bad mother. Mother is always a mother. That's what is the general tendency of a woman. Because the motherhood is always is endowed in a woman. And therefore, she is having that Matruka Varna Rupini or Matrukarana Drishti. Then she stopped her Nimesha and Animesha, this kind of fluttering eyelids. Then she stopped. Is only not having a purpose, just to flow forth her Karuna on that. I think it's so beautiful, this particular sloka, where whatever thing that is found in the personality of Parameswari or Parameswara, they have got a meaning and they have got a purpose and they have got a message. And that's what we find in this beautiful sloka. And Dharanidhara Rajan Yatanaya is being described here. Now when we go to the next important sloka, then of course as I'm talking and sometimes we can have a session if you have got doubts or questions. You can shoot them to me if possible. If I know, I'll try to explain this, because Soundarya Lahari is taken to be such an important text for which there are more than 40 commentaries, 36 to 40 commentaries have come originally. And whoever read Soundarya Lahari, people are not contented, including Prabhakar. Let us understand the slokas and let us try to look the meaning in the words and the expressions and the communication which Shankara wants to make regarding the beauty, power, existence, and etc. of Devi for Lalita Tripura Sundari. And so, she called, and also giving her different names. We have been seeing, she is called as Hamsini, she is called as Harvidhara Rajanya Kanya. She has been given different names. And in the next sloka also, one more name that Shankaracharya is giving to her and adding to the feather. I mean, one more feather in the Namavali of Lalita Parameswari. I am reading the sloka. When this particular sloka, I mean, before that 55 which I did it, is useful for relief of diabetics and success over enemies. So, diabetic problems are there. Kidney, I told you already. So, what diabetes people can receive the sloka for the benefit, because the constancy of the working of the kidneys and improvement in that will be there. Om Bhava Parne Karne Japanatanaya Japanayana Saisunya Chakita Niriyante Troye Niyatamani Vesha Shaparita Yam Jasrihi Vadjachada Putakavadam Kuvalayam Jahati Pratyushe Nishicha Vijata Nishicha Vigatayapravishati. I repeat, Tavaparne Karne Japanayana Vaisunya Sikita Niliyante Tuye Niyatamani Vesha Shaparika Yam Chasri Pratthachana Putakavatam Kruvalayam Jahati Pratyushe Nishita Vigatayapravishati. So, here, one more name I told you, Aparne. Parvati is called as Aparna. And many people long to have that Aparna name. And the beauty is that Aparna is Na Parnani Asya Sa Aparna. That is, when Parvati was doing her penance, she was using for some time the bed of leaves. She was sleeping, she was lying down on the bed of leaves and doing penance. She has done very, very hard penance in order to win the heart of Shiva, and all how hard the penance Parameshwari did is beautifully described by Kalidasa in his Kumara Sambhava. If you just happen to glance through the fifth canto of Kumara Sambhava, then you can see how she became ultimately Aparna. And when she became Aparna, Vikrama became very much attracted to her, and he became Sankarsana Murti. Let me say that she gave up using the leaves also as a part of her bed. She just slept on the hard surface of the ground where there is no kind of coverage at all. Therefore, even though many people are sleeping in Kurulan bed, they don't get sleep. What about Parvati? Imagine. She was sleeping in my, completely thinking of Shiva in her mind, upon the heart. That's why she was given the name as Aparna. She has relinquished even the Parnas as her support or bed. That's why Aparne Karne. And Japanayana Paisunya Chakita, Japanayana Paisunya Chakita, Nileyante Tuye Niyatam Animeshaha Shafarika. Now there is a description of Shafarika, there is a description of Kuvalaya, their nature, and that is being transferred or applied to the view to the eyes of Goddess Parameshwari. So, here Shankaracharya called, Shankaracharya is composing his own list of Devi Namavali. In fact, such Namavali is prepared, and I have covered all the Devi Namavali of Soundarya Lahari, made them to go more than 200. And that I published the Soundarya Lahari Prayoga Yoga, and there you can see so many things. For example, I want to say you, quote some Dharani Dharanajanyatanaye, Pasupati Parati Nahudade, Ishana Nayate, Gotradhara Patni, Uttam Sakalike, and Shive, Janani, Shimagirisute, Mahatikroha Kalite, Bhagavati, Bhavani, Aho Purushika, Tuhinagiri Kanye, Himagirisute, Saranye, oh, so when. Now you have got one more word in that list, Aparna. And so there is no limit for the Guna Ganana of Devi, but Shankaracharya is trying to give more and more, because she is known as Ananda Virya. Virya is that the prowess or the qualities endowed in her cannot be completely exhausted. She is called a swai. Now, O Aparna, the Safarika is the female fish, are hiding within the water, having no fluttering of eyes, being afraid of secret messages which your eyes get being close to your ears. And this seems definite, niyatam. This is a definite one, it's a thing. And the black lotus is also in the next example is all night closed, when the eyes closed, and they open their eyes, their petals. The eye of the lotus is the petal. So they close the petals when night falls. And when sun comes up, they open the petals. That is, they open the eyes. And there is a message. So it is natural for the female fish to remain in water with no fluttering to the eyes. Looking at this, Kautilya in Arthashastra makes a wonderful comparison regarding the officers. So when they take bribes, when they do so many things, nobody can find out, especially the bribing. So, just like the fish, it is very hard to know when the eyes open, when the eyes close, and when they take bribe, and when they do not take. So like that, Kautilya used beautiful comparison here. The phenomena is described to be owing to the beauty of eyes, ears, and the facial beauty of Devi Parameshwari. The objects seem to feel that, and that is, they are nowhere comparable or close to the Saubhagya of the eyes of Devi. The lotus, that generally people compare the eyes to Meenas, eyes to the lotuses, Meenakshi or Kanyadalakshi and so on. But in Shankara's imagination goes a little beyond, say that these two are ashamed that they no way go closer to the beauty of the eyes of Parameshwari, and so they hide themselves inside the water, after the water, that they are scared very much. So here we have got what we call as Atishayokti Alankara, which is employed by Shankara. See, in the previous sloka, we have seen the Utprecha, imagination, where there is imagination, but here there is the Atishayokti. The kind of attribution is unique, not common in description by the other poets. The address for, and it is a, so I told you about the na parnani chene api itya parna parvat. Yes. Then, tapas is an individualistic one, but the beauty in it is that he, the goddess, likes all that form of penance, though hard. Shankaracharya has attested the form of penance, the kind of penance could be anything. I told you when I was explaining the 27th sloka, where japo jalpa silpam sakalavikudra virachana and etc. enme vilasitam. There he has given you 13 forms. In whatever manner you do worship, Shiva and Parvati become pleased. It is not necessary that I am not doing this, I am not doing this, I am not. Whatever you pick up, whatever you like, whatever is convenient, that you follow, that it, that itself, Devi and Deva become completely happy. That's why here also the beauty of Parameshwari is matchless. And the final terminal point that she has taken or adopted to worship Shiva, lying down on hard ground, relinquishing the use of the parnas. And that has made Shiva to come to relieve, to make, to come and hold the hand of Parvati, stop her when she was about to go away. That's why, and Shiva comes and holding the hand, you should look at the fifth canto. Adya prabhutyana vadangita vasmidara krita sabodhana rapohihi. I am purchased, he says, Shankara says to Parvati, I am purchased by you, by the amount of the penance you have done for me. The price you have paid for to win my heart is your tapas. Now, Adya Asmidasaha. Today onwards, I have become your servant. So that was the achievement or the merit that she approved or she got when she became Aparna, the final state. Therefore, in this sloka, you find that to the comparisons to which we made, the fish and the lotus, they fetch shy, they are hiding inside the water. So this is the compliment to Devi Parameshwari. And I stop here, just reading the next sloka.